guys, and welcome back to the series The Butterfly That Brought Us Together, written and narrated by yours truly, Stacey Holt. As always, if you'd like to show your support, you can like, subscribe, and comment. Back to the story. Chapter 9. Her Secret. "You're lying! Again!" she protested.
"What? What did he say?"
Hawk Moth yelled. "Shut up! Shut up! Shut up!" Marinette fell to her knees, fighting Hawk Moth, trying to regain her self-control back.
"Fight him, Marinette. You can do it!"
Cat Noir yelled. Wait, there was something attached to the bottom of her staff. It looked like the lucky charm that he made her as Adrian. That must be it. He jumped toward it.
"Cataclysm!"
he yelled and grabbed it, releasing her from her trance. He watched her fade back to her normal state and started to fall, but caught her.
"Huh? What happened?"
Marinette asked, looking around confused. The buildings around her were half destroyed and in pieces. People were scared, and some were in pieces or shattered.
Did I do this?"
she said, looking up at Kat.
"It's all right, princess. I handled it,"
he smiled, giving him her hand to help stand her up.
"Thanks for saving me. Did Ladybug not show up? Where is she?"
she asked, trying to seem innocent. Kat smirked and hugged her unexpectedly, catching her off guard.
"Kat!"
she exclaimed.
"Sorry, princess. I was just worried."
He let her go and breathed out a sigh of relief. He then lifted up his hair to reveal her earrings in response to her question about Ladybug.
"Your secret's safe with me, Bugaboo."
He winked. Marinette's eyes widened, and she jumped away from him.
"What? No! Bugaboo! I'm not your bugaboo! I don't even know what you're talking about!"
She turned away from him and crossed her arms.
"Go clean up the city, LB, and I'll talk to you tonight at the Eiffel Tower at 9 p.m.,
Kat said. Marinette turned to argue, but as she turned around, he was gone. She saw her earrings at her feet. She picked them up inside, putting them in, and hugged Tiki.
"It's good to have you back, Tiki." "Glad you're back too, Marinette,"
Tiki smiled.
"Now, let's fix this mess."
Everyone was still hiding from Fracture, so she was all right to transform and call on her lucky charm to clean everything up. And that's exactly what she did. Everything went back to normal. Instead of returning to school, she went home. She didn't want to go back and see everyone. She wanted to take a mental health day, and she explained to her parents what happened. Her parents were understanding, and they didn't mind. They asked every once in a while to help in the bakery, and then she got caught up on some homework. After school let out, Ollie and her friends came over to check on her, and came up to her room. They all made her laugh and told her that Chloe was out of line, yes, but a lot of stuff was going on at home with Chloe. Her parents were getting a divorce, and they think Chloe was going to have to move. Chloe was just simply upset and didn't know how to express herself and acted out to her friends.
"Yeah, I even slapped her across the face for you, girl," Alia said. "Felt bad, but felt good at the same time."
Alia laughed. Marinette laughed.
"Sorry again for, you know, shattering you guys," Marinette apologized.
Everyone forgave her and left. After dinner, Marinette did her homework and prepared to meet Cat Noir at the Eiffel Tower that night. Her nerves caused her legs to shake. He knew who she was. Did he still love her? Is that why he wanted to talk to her? Was he disappointed like she knew he would be?
"Calm down, Marinette,"
Tiki said.
"Ugh, do I have to go?"
Marinette asked.
"He can always come here to get you,"
Tiki laughed.
"You're right, I should just move,"
Marinette groaned.
"Just go,"
Tiki rolled her eyes playfully.
All right, Tiki, Sponson,"
she groaned. Thank you so much for watching. The next chapter will be available soon. If you haven't already, go ahead and check out my other series called Thunderstorms and Melting, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys!